First of all, I'd like to congratulate all the entries that came before me, and also good luck with all the entries that come after me. My name is Daniel. So I came from a company which is 25 years history in Hong Kong. It's called Remote Tech. But we are spinning off today trying to raise funding with this new call called Smart and On. Although we come from a rich history of manufacturing OEM products, this is 25-year-old product today. We all know that the industry has changed and evolved, and we should be making some products. We have a small group of people. Welcome everyone. We actually turn down the volume of impact is quite strong here. So it's more pleasing for people here. So without further ado, let me introduce what I'm going to present. Obviously, I'm going to go through a little bit about the background, the problems and opportunities that we're trying to tackle, and of course, our funding needs. So we have a rich history coming way back from Von Bell Computers. If those of you that are involved in the industry, you've probably heard about us manufacturing CDM computers back in the days. We've transformed. We've now an IoT smart home company. We have data as a service product, which actually a lot of our customers are in the IoT space. We have products that feature here. But what's important is we already have distribution. We're not big, but we're a very good value proposition. Today, we try to solve two problems. First of all, is the fact that the growth of mobile phones is going to reach 2 billion today by the end of the year 2016. And of course, some of those phones will be recycled, reused, or maybe have some way to extend their life cycle. Unfortunately, recycle is only part of the process. What our value proposition today is to advocate the fact that there's a possibility of reusing the phone, extending the life cycle. So I came from a rich telecommunication background. Now the reason why we need to reuse these phones is statistics tell us today that 50% of the phones today, whether it's in Australia, whether it's in Canada, are actually sitting at home. A lot of you might have spare phones that are sitting right now in the storage. And our value proposition is, of course, first of all, is the extent of the use. McKinsey actually worked from a foundation called MacArthur Foundation to advocate about reuse life cycle. The second problem that we're trying to solve is global climate control. The temperature is rising, our seas are wide rising, and this is a very real problem. Today, this year, and of course last year, we hit record high in Hong Kong, okay? Record high temperature around all the cities, and particularly Hong Kong, the urban city climate obviously brings all these problems together, because if the heat is hitting us, what we're going to use is we're going to actually turn the aircon a little more. Now, I'm not saying that our value proposition is particularly interesting, but what's interesting is there are a lot of products that prove the market is coming. There are the award-winning products that's from Hong Kong, that's called NB Labs. They came up with products that won an award. We ourselves has been enabling a lot of products that also target the same market. So the problem we're trying to solve, just to give you some perspective, in Hong Kong, 1/3 of the electricity in the residential market is consumed in air conditioners. Now obviously this is global. So as a company that has been involved in the products, we have distribution. We have 7% products that is in the C-Wave category. What we are trying to do today is to raise funds for a smart aircon project that can also deliver a product that is suitable for European, US market, as well as the Asian market. So that's why I've shown you here. Some of these are actual products that we have. That means we have tooling with firmware expertise. And there are some conceptual products. So the solution that we propose have already brought us some success. Because we have won a prestigious competition by Hong Kong Institute of Engineers late last year all the way to early this year. We've outbeaten a lot of competitive entries from MTR, Auto, you name it, because we are down to earth. We've been producing products for 25 years, so we know how to make products. solution, the use case, the background, and the value proposition is what we call for. So today, for a 25-year company, we're spinning off and we want some funds. We want growth capital. So with a US patent design, patent pending design, we have actually secured a better way, a business model for mobile carriers to work with us. They can resell all these products by way of reuse and encouraging their customers to reuse their whole phone. At the same time, they can probably sell another subscription. At the end of the day, it extends the value from all the way from a current value proposition to a better value proposition by extending the way to the home with a series of products. But that's not all. What we're trying to do, this is the actual thermostat that we have in place. This is actually for US market today. The design has been well received by a lot of our customers. And what we are trying to develop is also basically an entry to the market. Everybody talks about ecosystem. The majority of the ecosystem are actually led by US company or other strong contenders. We, as a Hong Kong company, can also build an ecosystem that extends opportunity to all other innovators, all other collaborators. And I believe Intan has all this component, assets, supply chain expertise to manage these. And these are just a reference of our customers that have been using our database and our chipset technologies. So, and this is what we do. We basically have data services that we have the access to, all the IR codes, infrared codes that are existing today. So we offer two opportunities, just to close off. One is a connectivity using infrared codes to the last mile or smart home. But at the same time, we have a patent technology that purposely is designed for a business model for the carriers. And the carriers can be partners because they can upsell and resell and also participate in this energy management value proposition. So this is why we thought about the distribution. So to close off, this is what we're trying to secure. We want to spin off as a new code with $3 million for 50% equity. You get one bought seat. So post-money valuation, you're looking at about $20 million. And these are some of the purpose. And obviously, these are all well thought out. We have some core technology, IP, and we want to start fresh and to work with all the people in Intan and financial community. So thank you for your time. I'll be happy to answer any questions.
Thank you, Daniel. Questions from the panel?
Hello. I'm sitting here and trying to understand really what you're focusing on. So on the one hand, you're talking about controlling the climate and the temperature. On the other hand, recycling the mobile phone. Can you explain the connection between the two and what you're focusing on?
Thank you for the question, Chen. Okay, first of all, the go-to-market, a lot of the typical assets of customers today, the most impactful one is actually mobile carriers. They have a lot of customers. The pain point is how to reduce a lot of the trading phones. So the pain point for the carriers, for all the distribution, if you think about all the carriers or mobile worker or network operators out there, the challenge for them is actually when they sell or ask for a contract, what can they offer, right? So the patent inventions that we have solve one of the problems. At the same time, actually, that product used by design philosophy uses very little material because we're using the handphone as a dock. Yeah? So we're using the dock means that then the old phone can be used. Right? So that was, I think, the missing part that was kind of displaced away. So that answered the question. Second question is, why do they become part of value chain? Because throughout all these carriers, whatever they sell, whatever service they do, it's actually generating a lot of, consuming a lot of electricity. And actually, all your charges, everything that you use actually consumes for once they can actually participate in the ecosystem, become part of this smart icon campaign, and they can actually have a good message to all the customers. So it's very actually their financial impact, their social impact, and their environmental impact. So obviously energy management, that part, we all know about the market for Nest and a lot of these others. These are just backup slides. The current market for the market space that we are in is actually related to, obviously, on the top of the food chain, obviously, it's Nest and all that. But if you look down at M&A right now, it's a good indicator that all these are actually going to the market. That means potentially, as an exit, we have trade sell opportunity. IPA being 25-year-old company. So this is hopefully answering some of the question why we want to get involved in solo operator. I think we'll talk in the background in order to understand every detail of how they want to survive the business. Any other questions?
One question about the what's your revenue model? Are you essentially becoming a reseller of some of the peripheral controls?
Thank you, sir. The question is related to the business model where I get the reference. So there are two revenue streams. One is basically the sell device. The second model is actually the cloud services that actually we sell to end user or through the operator to sell to the end user. And we, in this respect, we actually partner with Microsoft to develop that platform and use technology so that we can actually go to market with a technology neutral product.
One thing I'm trying to clarify is, you know, I'm thinking, speaking for Nest, they're trying to do two things. One thing is they build a barrier so that they can sell as many kind of devices as possible of their own.
Yeah.
And the other thing is they want to be the de facto standard so that other small vendors will have to be compatible with their existing platform and framework. Well, how do you think you fit in this?
Let me explain. Today, if you kind of look at the phones, the home consumer appliances at home today, the install base, majority of those are Android, infrared. And today, there's two companies that's in the world that actually have access to what we call the worldwide infrared database. One is just a company called UEI, and the other one is us. The UEI company is known to the community as Intel. We are known as the EMR. So as a small company, SME home company, we actually have some data to spec, make it unstructured data, become spec. And this is why you see customers like this. This is a VC funded company, $54 million, German company, Tavor, smart agency. Competitive product in the marketplace selling for about $195. Our value proposition for new product will be about $100. And software, in this case, day to day, use our technology. A Taiwanese company called Zhongwen, day to day, and it's made by contract. Okay? Today, they use our technology. So, do we have something that is at the lowest level denominator in terms of spec? Absolutely.
On that note, do you think that IR is going to here to stay or is going to be made obsolete by other, Zigbee? You mentioned Zigbee, but Zigbee and other protocols.
Will it be obsolete eventually? Yes. This is why this is a perfect timing for us to go into the market with a better product. If we go into the market 10 years ago, nobody could know how to actually use it because smartphone adoption is still not there. Right? But today, if I had a speed equipment that goes into the household, then the other innovations that we talk about, eventually, it's all Bluetooth. We're already in there. So our tech is actually based on DLP. So hopefully, that explains why we have major partnership with BLE. Chipset companies, you name it, we have adopted our reference, our SDK already. That's why we have been enabling our customers. And this one is our quality. Is there any other questions? The docking station was pilot price, user end use price about $69. If you think about the reason why this design is so novel, and this is why we have patent pending, and I took a view, right, that, is because every other product today, I mean our customers, they have to repeat and design the product with Wi-Fi chipsets, everything in there. Whereas I actually eliminate all these and reuse the computational power and connectivity. Now this one, all of my customers' connectivity is using Wi-Fi, maybe Bluetooth, but doesn't matter. My connectivity options have been enhanced a lot more because I use the handphone. And the handphone is, I've just shown you, you know, the two problems we solve: indoor connectivity, reuse of the phone, extend the life cycle, it's more green. I use less material, so less digital waste. So the whole design philosophy was green. And encourage the whole concept of energy management.
Thank you, Panel, for your questions.
Great, thank you.
Thank you, Daniel.